the middle 1880s, the Fremont, Elkhorn, and Missouri Valley Railroad, later to become a part of the Chicago and Northwestern Railroad, built through northern Nebraska, on into eastern Wyoming, and up into the Black Hills of South Dakota. The Cowboy Line was nicknamed simply because the Northwestern and its predecessor, the Elkhorn, ran through some very remote and some very rancher-filled country out here in the West. Over the past 3 or 4 years, many changes have occurred on the former Western Division of the Chicago and Northwestern. We invite you to embark on a video history of the Northwestern's West End with us, with narration by Jack Sitch. Our trip over the Cowboy Lines begins at Norfolk, Nebraska.
Construction on the Norfolk to Chadron line began at Fremont, Nebraska on New Year's Day, 1870. Trackage was built slowly northwestward bound until the Elkhorn's line reached Chadron in July 1885. Terminals and crew change points were established at Norfolk, Long Pine, Cody, and Chadron in the steam era. Steam ruled the line until the early 1950s when diesels began to replace them. The last passenger train left Chadron in 1958, as did the last steamer. After a 1984 flood east of Norfolk, trains began running over the Union Pacific between Norfolk and Fremont. At Long Pine, we will witness what was the last train on the line before its abandonment on December 1, 1992. The 6893 heads the last train to Norfolk on its final run. Gives a wave as the 6848 gets set to make its final run to Chadron. In 1990, photographer Rick Mills captures what was Northwestern's BFPRA, Belle Fourche Proviso Yard train for Chicago, rolling over the Niobrara River Bridge just east of Valentine.
Yeah.
Fireman houses one of the largest grain elevators on the line. Here, GP40 5521 passes on its way to Norfolk in March of 1990. The final train reaches its destination of Chadron. The one loaded car for Dakota Steel will be hooked to an empty train that will go to Rapid City the following day. Construction on the coal line was completed in 1984. The line, which runs from South Morrill, Nebraska to Shawnee Junction, Wyoming, is the newest constructed line on the Northwestern, with a portion of it built over the original Chadron to Lander line. South Morrill is the interchange point between the Chicago and Northwestern and the Union Pacific. Loaded trains coming from the mines going east from this point will be taken by the UP to North Platte, then on to its appointed destination, while the CNW handles all the trains to the mines for loading and back to South Morrill. Thank you. GE test train number 001 sits in the yard for maintenance before its test run. At the time of production, the C&NW was in the process of purchasing 35 new GE locomotives. The South Morrill yard also houses a minor maintenance facility where locomotives are fueled, filled with sand, greased, and inspected for any minor defects. Major maintenance is done in Marshalltown, Iowa, and Proviso Yard in Chicago. The yard also utilizes a locomotive Y so that eastbound locos can easily be used as westbounds in a matter of minutes. The building houses the local dispatch center for train organization and termination. Trains that are operating on the line are then dispatched out of Chicago.
Come by me now.
Okay. All right. They'll be leaving all up there in about 5 minutes.
Okay.
Thanks.
Greg. Hi. Hey,
'Eastbound load heads over the Highway 26 bridge, which also crosses Burlington Northern's main line from Alliance, Nebraska to Guernsey, Wyoming. The Northwestern merges with this same line at Shawnee Junction in Wyoming. Crandall is the eastern point where the newly constructed coal line connects to the original Crawford to Casper line. The old trackage is evident in the background, with extra empty hoppers being stored. Thank you. In the town of Lusk, the old depot is still used today. Redwood Water Tower in Lusk is still in place today. It was built in 1886 by the Fremont, Elkhorn, and Missouri Valley Railroad, which then became a part of the Chicago and Northwestern. Chicago and Northwestern's GE C40-8 number 8542 is specially painted with a Wyoming Centennial logo. Here at West Miles, we get a glimpse of a meet from the deck of the 8542. Shawnee is the western point where the coal line connects the original Chicago and Northwestern line. Here the 8533 pulls a loaded train to South Morrill, then to its final destination in Wisconsin. Shawnee Junction is a point where the Chicago and Northwestern joins with the Burlington Northern Line north to the mines. The joint line sees approximately 40 to 50 trains from the two railroads daily. Belle, Wyoming is the northern crew change point on the coal line. From here, the Belle crew takes the empty trains to the mines for loading, then brings them back to Belle, where they are relieved by a rested South Morrill crew. Reno Junction, the 8547 pulls out of the Black Thunder Mine Spur onto the main line. This train was just loaded from Black Thunder for Wisconsin Electric Power in Pleasant Prairie, Wisconsin. Black Thunder Junction, BN's 5517 heads for the mine to load its train for Kansas City Power and Light Company. Pool power from Kansas City Southern, Santa Fe, Southern Pacific, and Union Pacific frequents many of Burlington Northern's coal trains out of the basin. West of Chadron, the Elkhorn, Chicago, and Northwestern built as far as Lander, Wyoming in 1907. The primary traffic over the years before the Wyoming coal boom were oil and livestock by the trainload. The line from Lander to Riverton was abandoned in 1972, and operations between Casper and Riverton ended in 1988. A flash flood along the White River put a premature end to operations west of Crawford, Nebraska, to Crandall Junction, Wyoming in May 1991. Since then, the Burlington Northern interchange at Crawford has become the Northwestern's gateway. At the Highway 385 crossing, just west of Chadron, engineer Ken Crittenbrink heads to Dakota Junction, where he'll couple his train for the Burlington Northern in Crawford. As a Burlington Northern crew takes a load from the Chicago and Northwestern, a unit grain train passes on the main line headed for Alliance. With its empties, the Northwestern train heads back to Chadron, while the BN's C30-7, number 5099, leads its Bentonite special up Crawford Hill to Alliance. To the Black Hills was begun at a point 5 miles west of Chadron in 1885. Trains rolled north from Dakota Junction to Boomtown Buffalo Gap in 1885, Rapid City in 1886, and finally to Deadwood and Belle Fourche in 1890. A narrow gauge system was built above Deadwood to the gold mines and remained in place until 1928. The main line from Belle Fourche was extended another 20 miles into Wyoming in 1948 to tap the bentonite traffic. The last passenger train from Rapid City to Chadron ran in 1954, and the final Dakota 400 left Rapid City eastbound in 1960 on the Northwestern's 1907-built line across South Dakota to Chicago. That line was sold to the Dakota, Minnesota, and Eastern Railroad in 1986. That sale left the Chadron to Colony line as a last remnant of the Western Division of the C&NW. Chadron was established in 1885 with the arrival of the Fremont, Elkhorn, and Missouri Valley Railroad. It was a crew terminal and division point from its earliest days to the present. Until the late 1960s, Chadron was the headquarters of the Northwestern's Black Hills Division, which was renamed the Western Division. The Western Division was abolished in 1989. Today, the Crawford to Rapid City to Colony line is simply the Colony line on the West End. Now leaving the yard, engineer Bob Sharp heads the Chadron Rapid City Extra towards Dakota Junction, where they will head north to their destination of Rapid City. Passing by Ulrich, South Dakota, we now get the engineer's perspective as we pass over the Highway 18 crossing.
Now they finally got it fixed. Now we're doing 10 miles an hour.
Thank you.
After nearly 70 miles of the 10-mile-per-hour jointed rail, the line finally turns to 40-mile-per-hour ribbon rail as Bob Sharp clicks the train to throttle 8 as it nears closer to Rapid City.
Yeah.
With the Rapid City Regional Airport Control Tower 15 miles in the distance, a Rapid City to Chadron Extra with a single SD40-2 passes milepost 90. Out of the Rapid City Yard, 6808 heads south for Chadron. Then soon after, it will make its journey to Crawford for another interchange with the Burlington Northern. Dakota, Minnesota, and Eastern Railroad was created in 1986 with the sale of the Rapid City to Winona, Minnesota line by the Chicago and Northwestern. Traffic is largely dependent on bentonite clay, cement, and wood products that are interchanged with the Chicago Northwestern at Rapid City. Part of the DM&E's locomotive fleet are XCNW SD9s, which saw service on the same line prior to the sale. Other power came from rivals Milwaukee Road and Sioux Line, plus seasonal leased power from the likes of Duluth, Wasabi, and Iron Range, Burlington Northern, and even from the Northwestern. Rapid City Roundhouse was built in the 1890s and is still used today. Here engines are fueled and prepped for either the Belle Fourche return train or the Chadron Extra. Thank you. The 5082, with engineer Bill Neary at the throttle, passes by the Dakota Cement Plant, a major shipper on the C&NW. Just north of the cement plant is a peatling gravel and rock quarry, who is another user of the Northwestern. Gravel from here is used as ballast on the line. The line runs adjacent to the Black Hills National Cemetery, just a few miles east of Sturgis. Whitewood is the home of the Consolidated Woodchip Yard. Here, woodchips are loaded into these modified boxcars. Listen to the conversation between the train crew as they drop off empties to be loaded the next day.
Five more, I suppose. Couple.
In St. Ange, the inspection truck rushes to clear the line as the Belle Fourche train heads through. Belle Fourche, and also 14 miles west to Colony, Wyoming, are the American Colloid Company bentonite plants. Northwestern cars are loaded at these plants and then taken to Rapid City, where they either head out via DM&D or to Crawford via Chicago Northwestern. In Belle Fourche, Bill Neary pulls the loaded bentonite cars to Rapid City, where they will be transferred this time to the DM&E.